The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At that time, when Jesus had come to Nazareth, he said to the people in the synagogue, "Truly I say to you, no prophet is acceptable in his hometown. But in truth I tell you, there were many widows in Israel in the days of Elijah, when the heavens were shut up 3 years and 6 months, and a great famine came over all the land. And Elijah was sent to none of them, but only to Zarephath in the land of Sidon, to a woman who was a widow. And there were many lepers in Israel in the time of prophet Elisha, and none of them was cleansed, but only Naaman the Syrian." When they heard these things, all in the synagogue were filled with wrath, and they rose up and drove him out of the town and brought him to the brow of the hill on which their town was built, so that they could throw him down the cliff. But passing through their midst, he went away. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters, in the Gospel today, Jesus highlights the faith of two pagans, the Jews called non-Jews, the people who did not belong to the people of God, as pagans, cursed by God. But Jesus is highlighting the faith of two of them, the widow of Zarephath, a pagan, and Naaman the Syrian, another pagan. There was a famine in Israel, and God said to prophet Elijah, "You go to Zarephath. I have appointed a widow there to give you bread." Elijah went, obeying God's word. And there he met a widow at the city gate, Zarephath. A widow picking twigs. The prophet went to her and said, "Please give me something to eat. I'm hungry." The widow said to him in all helplessness, "I have nothing to give you. All I have is a little flour in my jug and a little oil in my jar to make a little piece of bread for me and my son to eat. That's all, and then we shall die." But at the word of the prophet, understanding this was the prophet of God, the widow was ready to let go of the little she had. She gave that piece of bread to the prophet, and she was rewarded for that. In her jar, in her jug, there was no scarcity for the material to make food for her in the whole season of famine. And Naaman, as we heard in the first reading, he was the military commander of the Syrians, a leper. He came from Syria. At the word of the prophet Elisha, in all humility, he dipped himself 7 times in River Jordan, and he came out totally cleansed. And Jesus referred to these two people of faith from the pagan land, not from the Jewish tribe. The context of this teaching of Jesus is very pertinent. This was the beginning of the public ministry of Jesus. After having been baptized in River Jordan and fasted 40 days and 40 nights and defeated Satan in the temptations, according to Luke, Jesus comes to Nazareth, the place where he grew up, and inaugurates his public ministry. And that means the offer of salvation was in his own hometown, quoting Prophet Joel in the synagogue, quoting Prophet Isaiah in the synagogue. Jesus said, I'm sent by God, anointed by the Holy Spirit, to bring the good news, the season of God's favor, to proclaim liberty to captives, and sight to the blind, and release to the oppressed. And today, in your hearing, this word is come true, an offer of salvation to everyone sitting in the synagogue. But the people were not ready to take it. They were impressed by his teaching, but scandalized by the humble home surrounding of Jesus. They said, isn't he the son of a carpenter, Joseph, son of Mary? And aren't his relatives all with us? How can he speak in such great wisdom? They were scandalized. In fact, such wisdom should have come from a rabbi trained in Jewish law. They couldn't believe this. They could not accept Jesus as the Messiah, as the Son of God. They looked at him as a mere human being, son of a carpenter. And they rejected him. To such a great extent, they wanted to throw him down from a precipice and kill him. Look at the contrast. The Jews, the people of God, whom God had chosen and formed by the teachings of the prophets to accept the Messiah in faith, they rejected the Messiah when he came, looking at his humble home surrounding. But the non-Jews, they accepted the word of God, and they were saved. Both Naaman and the widow of Zarephath, they were rewarded for their faith. Naaman was healed of his leprosy, and the widow got her jug and her jar filled for the time of the season of famine. It's good for us to know, how do we look at Jesus? We can get used to Jesus. Such a familiar way. We do not look at him anymore as the Son of God who can save us, who can bring salvation to us, who can bring the season of God's favor to us in the moments of the captivity of sin, In the moments of the captivity of despair, in the moments of terrible trials and struggles, he can bring comfort and salvation. Well, am I able to look at Jesus as my Savior, as the Son of God sent to me by God the Father to proclaim the good news of salvation to me? Jesus said today, this word of God has come true in your hearing. How relevant is Jesus to me? If I do not accept him as the Savior, as the Son of God, sent by the Heavenly Father to save me, he would not mean anything to me. My religion would not save me. I need to accept Jesus as my personal Savior at every moment of my trial, of my temptation, of my struggle. And then I would know he's come, sent by the Heavenly Father, to save me, to make sure that I am not lost. Amen.